Let's see if we can actually play a game this time. This hand is not great. I mean, it does have Sejiri Step and Rune Ghost again, and Smother, which is okay, but we don't have any creatures. We have three Sepulchres, so I think I'm going to go ahead and mulligan this. This hand is a little bit better and a little bit worse. Like a mulligan? No, we'll go ahead and try this, and hopefully we just draw Steplings. If that first hand had a creature, then I would keep it. Otherwise, it was a little bit too weak for me. Oh my. Looks like we have a red-black player. So here, I think we're just going to play a Plains and ship the turn. Then we can play Ruin Ghost, Teetering Peaks, hit up, attack for three. Then play a Cartographer, etc., etc. And get things going. So, let's go ahead and play this in case we want to play Smother, because we're going to play Teetering Peaks next turn. Jeez, from mono red to mono black. We're just going to go ahead and take two more. And there's a Steplings. That's annoying. So we have a few options now. We can Teetering Peaks and get in for three, then play Steplings. That sort of opens us up to getting destroyed by removal. But if we play the Peaks, if we go and attack first, that may bait out some removal. So I'm going to go ahead and try that. We may see an Urge to Feed here. Yeah, I have the sneaking suspicion that that's actually what it is. So, well, we're going to attack anyway. See what he has anyway. Yeah, nothing. So, I'm going to forgo the holding on to the Brave. And no blocks. So let's see, what can we do now? We can do a lot of damage. We can play a land and then blink our Teetering Peaks, which will be another landfall trigger, and then enter the battlefield trigger. So that'll be six. And I think I like that. So let's go ahead and auto yield to that. I think I want to hold on to my Brave the Elements, because he seems like he's being pretty deliberate in the time that he's taking to click OK. So I'm just going to go ahead and smash with this guy. Bam. Can auto yield to that, even though it's going to be a new Teetering Peaks the next time. And then we can always, depending on, look, that's what we did. From mono red to mono black. So it's kind of annoying that we didn't actually get to play a real match, but that's unfortunately going to be the situation that unfolds sometimes when you're dealing with very aggressive decks that really need to hit their colored mana drops in the first few turns, like the Vampire Lacerator Core Outfitter deck, for example. It just doesn't really work out every now and then. So I hope we actually have a good round next round, because, that was a little disappointing. So I'll see you in a little bit.